Dear students, in this lecture, we are going to see the representation of operators in H in terms of real and imaginary operators using adjoint of an operator. So, let us see this representation. Theorem. Let T be an operator. Let T be an operator on H, operator on Hilbert space H, on Hilbert space H. Then T can be uniquely expressed, then T can be uniquely expressed as T is equal to A1 plus IA2, A1 plus IA2, where A1 and A2 are self-adjoint operators on H, where A1 and A2 are self-adjoint operators. Are self-adjoint operators on H. So, let us see proof of this representation. Proof we are going to divide in two parts. First part is existence part and second part is uniqueness part. Define operators. Define operators. A1 and A2 on H as. So, what do you mean by operators on Hilbert space? So, operator is simply a function from H to H which is linear and bounded or linear and continuous. So, define operators A1 and A2 on H as A1 is equal to 1 upon 2 t plus t star and A2 is equal to 1 upon 2 i t minus t star. Then consider A1 plus IA2, A1 plus IA2. So it is easy to observe with this choice we will get 1 upon 2 t plus t star plus i times 1 upon 2 i t minus t star. So with simplification we will get this as I gets cancelled. 1 upon 2 t star minus 1 upon 2 t star gets cancelled. So what we have is this 1 upon 2 t plus t that equals to t. That equals to t. Thus, we obtain the result that t is equal to a1 plus ia2, and we could also add this t star, we could write it as a1 minus ia2. Let us verify this property as well. Also, it is easy to observe that a1 minus a2 is equal to 1 upon 2 t plus t star ia2. Yes, that is correct. T plus t star minus I times 1 upon 2i t minus t star. Yes, t minus t star. So again I and I gets cancelled. 1 upon 2t minus 1 upon 2t gets cancelled. So what we are left with is this 1 upon 2t star plus t star, and that equals to t star. So thus we have represented t star as a1 minus ia2. In existence part, we must verify that a1 and a2 are self-adjoint. So let us verify this. Also, a1 star is equal to, we have to take adjoint of this, so that is equal to 1 upon 2 t plus t star and adjoint of this. So this is going to be equal to, we are going to use two properties over here, 1 upon 2, so note that alpha t conjugate star equals to alpha conjugate t star, and secondly note that t1 plus t2 star equals to t1 star plus t2 star. So these two properties we have to use here. So that is going to be equal to 1 upon 2, conjugate of 1 upon 2 will be 1 upon 2 itself because it is real number. So it is going to be equal to t star plus tt star star, and that equals to, if you simplify this, this is going to be equal to 1 upon 2 t star plus t, since t star star equals to t, and that is going to be equal to 1 upon 2 t plus t star, because it is commutative addition we have, and that is going to be equal to a1. So thus a1 star is equal to a1. Thus a1 star is equal to this. A1 star is equal to A1. Again, consider A2 star, that is adjoint of A2. This equals to adjoint of the operator 1 upon 2i t minus t star conjugate. Again, you have to use these two properties, first and second. By using these two properties, this I could write as minus 1 upon 2i, because conjugate of 1 upon 2i is going to be minus 1 upon 2i. You verify this on your own. Verify that conjugate of this is equal to minus 1 upon 2i, then minus star minus T star star. So that is going to be equal to minus 1 upon 2i T star minus T. Since T star star equals to T, again we are going to use this result over here. This is equal to 1 upon 2i T minus T star, T minus T star, and this is going to be equal to again A2 itself. So we have proved that A2 star. This proves that, or say A2 star is equal to A2. So this completes the existence part. We proved four properties. This is first, second, say this is third, and we proved the fourth property. So with these four properties, we have completed the existence part. Now let us see the uniqueness part of, let us see the uniqueness part. So for uniqueness part, let A1 and A2 be, let A1 dash and A2 dash be self-adjoint operators, be self-adjoint operators on H such that T is equal to A1 dash plus I A2 dash and T star is equal to A1 dash minus I A2 dash. So this is first property. So this is second property or second statement or equation. We have to prove that A1 is equal to A1 dash and A2 is equal to A2 dash. So by using these two, we can write by first plus second, we can easily get that this gets cancelled. So what we have is this 2A1 dash is equal to T plus T star, which implies that A1 dash is equal to 1 upon 2 T plus T star, and that equals to A1. So thus we proved that A1 dash is equal to A1. Similarly, we can prove that A2 dash is equal to A2. So let us prove this. By first minus second, we get that if you subtract second equation from first, this term A1 dash and A1 dash will get cancelled. So what we will have is this T minus T star is equal to minus 2i A2 dash. So this implies that A2 dash is equal to 1 upon 2i T minus T star, and that equals to A2. So thus, again we proved that A2 dash is equal to A2, and this completes the uniqueness part that A1 dash is equal to A1 and A2 dash is equal to A2. Let us see the definition. The operators adjoint operators, self-adjoint operators. In the theorem which we have proved just now, we have completed the proof. In the theorem where T is equal to A1 plus IA2 and P star is equal to A1 minus IA2, theorem are called. So A1 is called the self adjoint operator. I should write here A1 and A2. So A1 and A2 are called real and imaginary parts of T respectively, are called real and imaginary part of T respectively, imaginary part of T respectively. So here note that T we are representing as A1 plus IA2, and A1 is called real part or real operator, and A2 is called imaginary operator or imaginary part. So note that every operator can be expressed using self-adjoint operators. Thank you.